All right, girls, welcome to your fourth session of netball during our lockdown. We're going to be doing ladder work today. All right, so ladder work equals footwork. We want to make sure that we're nice and light on our feet, quick feet, and that we have control of our body. So it's very important. Every day, if you can do this, do a little bit of footwork before your session of ball throws or attack training or defensive training. It's always important to do your footwork. All right, so I've made a ladder just out of tape. I've made it slightly bigger than a foot for each block. I haven't used the tape running down the side, but so you can use your imagination for that. Important while we're doing the ladder work is that our chins are up and not looking into the ground. When we're on the court, we want to make sure that we have a view of the players, the ball, opportunity for interception, and to see those open spaces. If our head is down looking at the ground, we cut off our vision of the court. All right, girls, I hope you're going to enjoy the session. All right, girls, so the first one that we're going to do is just the normal run through. We're going to do each of these 5 times. So make sure you're using your arms on the side of your body, pumping up and down. And quick, 1 foot in each block. All right, for this one, we're going to do 2 feet in each block, but every time we're going to change our leading leg. So the first one I'm going to do, I'm going to lead with the right leg, so which means my right leg goes in first, there, and then the other leg, my left leg, in the same square. So, and there we go. We're going to do that 5 times, leading with the right, and 5 times leading with the left. Right, this one that we're going to do now, we're going to do lateral movements, which means my shoulders, hips and feet all facing against the wall, and I'm going to step together. All right, so as you can see, I'm now leading with my left. If I turn around, I'm still going to be leading with my left. So I can do left going down again as well, and then leading with the right. While you're doing this, you want to make sure that your chin is up and that you're not looking down. Whenever we're on the court, we want to make sure that our chins are up, so concentrate, not looking down at the lines when you're doing these exercises. Now this one, we're going to do double leg hops. It's also going to be for quick feet, both feet moving together. So I don't want to see how high you can hop, but that you're only on the balls of your feet. Two-legged hops. Right, this time we're going to move into single-legged hops, still facing forward, starting on the left, then going to the right. Make sure you do 5 on the right, 5 on the left. So there, again, just quick little feet. Make sure that you're staying on the ball of your foot and that there's not a hard landing. Nice and light on the feet, bending the knee and at the ankle. After we've completed our single-legged hops facing forward, we're going to move to single-legged lateral hops. So turning the body to the side, shoulders, hips, knees and feet in one direction. Again, bend at the knees and at the ankles so that it's a nice, light movement. And when you're doing this, make sure that you balance every time you land, that it's not just a motion of falling over to the next block. Again, using a lateral movement, we're going to do zigzag in and out. So in, out, out, in, out, out. Staying light on the balls of your feet and quick movement in and out of the squares. Right, we're going to do the river going forward. So we're going to go in, out, out. In, out, out. So I'm going to show you just a bit faster. In, out, out, in, out, out. And then to finish off, we're going to do 5 quick run-throughs. So they're pumping in with the arms, and we're going to do 5 quick run-throughs.